Growing up, there's one particular of my PE coaches that I remember from elementary school. We'll call him Coach Bob. And I remember him because he was my favorite of my PE teachers. He's a very kind man. He made you want to learn. He made you want to become stronger just because of the kindness that he exuded from him. And Coach Bob at one point ended up leaving us, and he went to go to serve in some African country. I can't remember which one, and I can't remember exactly what he was going to do. I just remember that he heard about an opportunity to go and help people. And being the kind of person he was, he jumped at that opportunity. Now, about a year or two later, he came back for a little bit and came to the school to visit us. And we were all really excited to see him. We rushed up, and I went up. It had been a long enough time that, you know, I wasn't sure if he remembered who I was, and so I asked him, do you remember who I am? I'll never forget, he looks at me and he says, "Oh, Trey, I can never forget you." I don't know if it was his tone or if it was just my lack of self-confidence. I couldn't see it being either. And so I sort of, you know, had that sort of, hey, response of, you know, what do you mean by that? You know, am I just some weird little kid and that, you know, that's the reason that you remember me, is just some defect that's in me? And, of course, Coach Bob, being the kind person that he was, we should know that's not it at all. Now, when we approach God, there's sort of a similar happening. We're often not sure that God knows who we are. And if he does, surely it's because of something wrong with us, some fault that can be found in us. It's because we're on his naughty list or something like that. It's because he has to keep tabs on us for some reason. We think that God knows us because of what's bad in us. But the opposite is true. God looks past all of that sin that clings to us, that clings to our being. And he sees at the core of us. He sees who we really and truly are. He sees to that being that Jesus brings out in us, that Jesus helps us to be by recreating us. We see that in Nathanael's interaction with Jesus. Because Jesus doesn't look at all the possible bad things that Nathanael does or has done. He doesn't look at Nathanael's response when he hears about Jesus and give him a hard time for saying, "Oh, you know, nothing good can come out of Nazareth. Well, I'll show you." He doesn't do any of that. What Jesus does is he looks immediately at the best quality, the quality that's right at the core of Nathanael. Nathanael, like us, he's surprised. He's surprised that God, that Jesus, would know him so fully, so deeply, to look past all of these awful bits and to get at right at that core. That God doesn't just see the worst of it all, but sees the best in us as well. And further, God, in knowing us, is trying to get to the point, to come to us, to approach us, so that we, too, can know God more fully, more deeply. So that we can know God to the depth of our very limited understanding of things. And this is what we see in the story in 1 Samuel this month. God is trying to reach out to Samuel so deeply, so personally, that Samuel not only gets that sense of God reaching out, he hears it. He experiences it in a very real and physical way. Now, Samuel in the story is still very young. This is before the days that he will become one of the great prophets and the last judge of Israel. He's still young and inexperienced. He doesn't know what's going on. He assumes that the voice he's hearing is the voice of his teacher and mentor, Eli. But fortunately for Samuel, he has his teacher and mentor, Eli. Eli is there for him. Eli is there to tell him, oh, this is what you're experiencing. You're experiencing God calling out to you. And this is what you need to do. This is how you need to respond to God's call. This is how you need to listen. It's very fortunate for Samuel that he has such a teacher and mentor that can tell him how to let God in, how to better listen to what God is saying to him. Would that we all would have such teachers and mentors in our own lives. God knows us. God knows us to the depths of our being. This isn't something for us to be frightened by. This isn't something for us to run away from, to shun. Because God doesn't just see that sinful, that wretched part of us that clings to our being. God sees past that. God sees to our very core. He sees us as the beings he created us to be. He sees us as the beings that will be recreated in Christ Jesus. And additionally, God wants us to know him as well. God wants to be one with us, wants to be in relationship with us. He shows that through Samuel, through sometimes these physical means. He shows that that is the depth that he wants us to know him, to come to him. So the question for us is, will we let him? Will we let God in to our lives? Will we listen to what God has to say to us? Because God came down to be one of us, to be one with us. He came down and wanted to be in relationship with us so much that he was willing to die for us. That is the depth to which God wishes for us to know that he knows us and for us to in turn know him. So let us stop and think. Will we do that? Will we let God in to our hearts? Will we listen? Will we let ourselves know God to the depths that God wishes for us to know him?